Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much. I'd like to welcome everybody to the incredible UPS Entertainment Extravaganza. This is the second annual event. Its purpose is to benefit the United Way, so I hope that's why we're all here. As everybody knows, UPS has been a longtime supporter of the United Way, and that's why we're all here tonight. We've got a lot of great acts lined up for you, and I know you all can't wait to get started, so we'll get rolling in just a moment. I have to take care of a couple of things. I want to introduce the band to you. The band tonight, thank you very much. The Boomerang Pilots, John, and at least right now, their invisible friend, Linda. So give them a round, please. Thank you very much. Okay, in the unlikely event of an emergency, we have several emergency exits around you. You see them all on this side. There's also a door back here that you can get out of in case the place blows up or something like that. Hopefully nothing like that will happen. My name is Craig Holmes, and I work in the Air Group Legal Department. I've been with UPS about 10 years now and have enjoyed every minute of it. There's a Dalmatian over there in case you didn't see him come in. But I've enjoyed every minute of my tenure here with UPS. I work in the Legal Department, as I said, and Peg had asked me, when she asked me to MC this event, she asked me if I could get up here and tell some lawyer jokes. I know nobody out there knows any lawyer jokes. I'm sure you've never heard anyone make fun of my profession. I know we've all heard them. In fact, I'm going to give you a few lobs, and then someone in the audience can yell out the answer. Are you all ready? Okay, here we go. What's the difference between a skunk and a lawyer dead in the middle of a road? I heard it. There are tire tracks. I mean, there are skid marks in front of the skunk. Thank you very much. Okay, joke number two. I have four of them. You have to sit through these. What's black and brown and looks good on a lawyer? Ah, thank you. Yes, the door, there you go. What do you call it if you have 2,000 chained lawyers at the bottom of the sea?
Good start.
Oh, that was too easy. I should have started with that one. Thank you very much. Your door prize will be waiting for you at the door. And finally, how do you tell if a lawyer is lying? Oh, yeah, there we go. Thought we'd start with a little audience participation. I wanted to tell you all a little story that kind of typifies what I believe my profession is all about. It's a dilemma that we face every day. There's an old woman, and she went to this lawyer because she needed a will written, as many people need to do, and he was charging her $100. Well, after the will was written, she showed up to pay for it, and she gave him a brand new, crisp $100 bill. As the lawyer took the payment, he noticed that really this crisp $100 bill had another bill attached to it. So actually there were two $100 bills. So as you can imagine, he had quite an ethical dilemma on his hand. That dilemma, of course, was should he tell his partner? Thank you. Thank you very much. Well, this is going too well. I'll have to save my other one for later. Okay, let's go ahead and get started with our first act. Our first act, his name is Jimmy Crawford. Jimmy's been with UPS for 12 years. He works in AMDC. He's worked in the hub. He's worked in the ramp. And my card here says that he will introduce the song himself. So I have no idea what it's going to be, but I'm sure we'll be mightily entertained. So a little smattering of applause, please, for Jimmy.
Testing. Okay, as I told you, my name is Jimmy Crawford, and I've been at UPS for 12 years. It's been about almost a year ago that I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. And I just cannot recommend it highly enough. The Lord has just really changed my life around for the better. And now the song I'm about to play, I wrote some time ago, and it's about the Bible. And now it's important for me to say that I mean, this song isn't even going to scratch the surface on the meaning of the Bible, but it might serve as a reminder that if we want God's blessing in our lives, We need to open it up and read it and take it for what it is, and it's God's Word. It's called It's All Been Written Here. Thank you.
Thank you, folks. Thank you very much, Jimmy. That was excellent. Good job. Okay, our next act, a gentleman by the name of Todd Smith, who does not want to be known as Hot Toddy, but it says it on my card, so I'm of course, compelled to say it. Todd's going to come out here and talk with us in a minute about how the United Way has touched his life personally. He has had some personal experience with the United Way, so he's going to share those with us. His father's in the audience tonight. His father's name is Warren Smith. Warren is on this side of the room, I'm told. I'm sure Todd will point him out for us. Todd's been with UPS for 2 years. He's worked in load planning, and he's worked in the employment center. He says he enjoys people, playing sports, and hanging out with his friends at WDJX. So, without further ado, Todd, come on out.
First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for being here tonight, and I just want to talk a little bit about what Metro United Way has done for me over the past 3 years. My father, 3 years ago, had to have quadruple bypass surgery, And shortly after that time, he came home and he got what they call a staph infection, and he was put back in the hospital for about a year and a half. And he developed what they call a Guillain-Barré syndrome disease, and that disease is it's a paralysis that paralyzes you from your head down. But it just so happened that my dad was one of the lucky ones, and it only went from his neck down, and he was in the hospital for quite some time. And me and my mom and my family, we just had to work hard with him to get him, and you know, to try to get him to get better. And it was a real hard time. And one day I was in Baptist East Hospital and I saw a representative from Metro United Way talking to someone. And when my dad came home, he had to have a lot of therapy, and he just had to have extensive therapy every day. I mean, it was just something that, you know, he had to do. And it just so happened that through the Metro United Way, there was a place called the Visiting Nurses Association through Metro United Way. And they came and they did extensive therapy with my father, and they told me and my mom stuff that we would be able to do. And I just thank God tonight that my dad is here, because the doctors have said that, you know, the people with this disease probably wouldn't be living today. And I'm proud that I can stand and say that my dad is here tonight and he is walking. And I just want to thank Metro United Way for being there and helping my family. And this song is dedicated to my father and my family and anyone here who is involved with Metro United Way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfills my needs. A lonely place to be, and so I learned to depend on me. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadows. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I'll live and I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the greatest love of all is happening to me. I found the greatest love of all inside. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadows. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I'll live and I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the greatest
is happening to me. I found the greatest love of all inside of me. The greatest love of all is easy to achieve. That special friend that you've been dreaming of leads you to a lonely place, find your strength in love. Thank
you very much. Thank you very much. Okay, our next act is called the Smoketown Kids in Youth. They go by the acronym of SKY. They're located at the Presbyterian Community Center at 760 South Hancock Street. Thank you very much. And they're under the direction of Harlina Chern Yalo. I hope I said that right. This is the fourth year of the company that's been in existence, and the focus of this program is to develop self-esteem and self-worth through performing arts, dance, music, and theater. So, if our dancers are ready, Deb says they are, let's go. Thank you.
Amen. Well, I'm running down the road trying to loosen my load. I got seven women on my mind. Four that want on me, two that want to stone me, one that she's a friend of mine. Take it easy, take it easy. Don't let the sound of your own wheels drive you crazy. We may lose and we may win, but we will never be here again. So hooking up by climbing in and take it easy. Well, I'm standing on a corner in Winslow, Arizona, such a fine sight to see. It's a girl, my lord, in a flatbed for her. Slow down and take a look at me. Come on, baby, don't say maybe. I got to know if your sweet love is gonna save me. We may lose and we may win, but we will never be here again. So open up, I'm climbing in, take it easy. Well, I'm running down the road trying to loosen my load. Got a world of trouble on my mind. Looking for a lover who won't blow my cover. She's so hard to find. Take it easy, take it easy. Don't let the sound of your own wheels drive you crazy. Oh, come on, baby, don't say maybe. I gotta know if your sweet love is gonna save me. You know we got it easy. Gotta take it easy.
All right, I said before the break that if you weren't careful and didn't watch your children closely, I might recruit them to come up here and say a thing or two. So I've got three children who just can't wait to come out here and tell a joke or two to us. So let's start off with, we'll go littlest to biggest. Come on out here, young lady. Clap, 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 clap. What's your name?
Kelly.
Kelly. How old are you, Kelly?
Five.
Five.
Where do you go to school?
Brandeis.
Do you? Okay. Do you have a joke for us?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead.
Where do the fish keep its money?
Well, I don't know. Where do fish keep their money?
In a riverbank.
Oh. All right. Well, I hope this one is as good as that one. What's your name, dear?
Jamie.
Jamie. Jamie, how old are you?
Seven.
Seven. Okay. Where do you go to school?
Brandeis.
And what grade are you in?
Second.
Okay. Is there anything you want to say before you tell your joke?
No.
How about your dad's a great guy or something like that?
You are my dad.
Oh. Perfect. Well, thank you. Thank you. Okay. See, when you get desperate, you grab the ones that you know you can get. Okay, Jamie. Why don't you tell us your joke?
Knock, knock. Boo. Why do you have to cry like that?
thank you, Jamie. Okay, and what's your name?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
And how old are you?
9.
Where do you go to school?
St. Athanasius.
What's your favorite color?
Red and purple.
No, pick one. What's your favorite color?
Red.
Okay. All right, you have a joke for us too, right? Are you ready? Good. Now, Elizabeth, you should know, was really drafted into this, okay? So, go for it.
Why did the chicken cross the road?
I don't know. Why did the chicken cross the road?
To prove to the possum it could be done.
Very good. Thank you very much. Well, I have one more lawyer joke I'm going to tell, so bear with me. And it's not the one that several of you told me during the intermission, which pretty much were all the same joke. But this is about a doctor, a lawyer, and a priest who were on a boat. And they're on the boat, and they're out taking a little excursion, a three-hour tour, if you will. And the wind started picking up, and the rain really started to hit them hard, and it became pretty clear that they weren't going to make it. They weren't going to be able to make it back to the shore. Well, they spied about 300 yards off a little island, and they knew that their only chance was to get to the island. Now, they had a rope in the boat, and they had to have the rope, else this joke wouldn't work. They had a rope in the boat, and one of them had to jump out and swim to the island, and when he got to the island, then he could pull the boat in, and they'd all three be safe. Well, who was going to go? They decided to draw straws. So they drew straws, and the priest happened to be first. So the priest jumped out into the water, started swimming toward the shore, and he got about 50 yards off, and all of a sudden there was this great commotion in the water, and the water started splashing up, and then you saw like fins going up in the air, and you saw a little blood and everything. So you knew the priest had just bit it. Well, the two that were left looked at each other, and they decided they had to do something because the wind just kept picking up, and the rain was really hitting them hard, and they knew that the ship was going to go down. So they drew straws. Well, the doctor drew the short end this time. So the doctor jumps in the water, and he didn't like it too much, but he had to go. So he jumps in. He starts swimming as fast as he can. He got about 100 yards, and that same splashing started happening. The fins were coming out of the air, and the doctor went under. The only person left was the lawyer. Well, the lawyer knew he didn't have a chance staying in the boat. He had to get out of the boat. Gale force winds were approaching. The skies were turning blue, a dark blue. It was so bad. So what he did was he jumped out. He swam as fast as he could, and he got about 100 yards away, and he knew he had a long ways to go, and a shark came up next to him, and the shark looked at him and said, "Jump on my back. I'll give you a ride." So the lawyer, that's not it. Hold on. I'll tell you when to clap. So then he jumps on his back. The shark swims to shore with the lawyer on his back, and the lawyer, of course, is quite perplexed, doesn't understand why this happened. And when he gets let off at shore, he looks at the shark, and he says, "I don't understand this. You ate the doctor, and you ate the priest. Why did you not eat me?" And the shark looks back at him, and he smiles, and he said, "Professional courtesy." Now, thank you. Okay, well, let's get rolling with our acts in the second half here. I'm going to introduce Edith Stein and her friend Paul Witte. They're going to sing two tunes for us. The first is called Molly St. George, and the second is called Moving Cloud. They both play with a local Celtic band called Gallo Glass, and Edith plays with Drowsy Maggie. Now, in real life, Paul is an assistant county attorney, and Edith is our air group continuous improvement coordinator. Now, this may or may not be their this may be their unrealized music, might be their main life, because I know they really like this. But just so you know, we're not above putting in plugs, so I'll plug this for you, or for them. Both bands can be heard on Sunday the 23rd at Locust Grove from 1 to 6. That's right, Sunday the 23rd from 1 to 6 at Locust Grove. That place, again, is Sunday the 23rd at Locust Grove from 1 until 6. That, folks, is tomorrow. So please join me in welcoming Edith and Paul.
Two tunes that we're going to play for you tonight are a combination of an Irish slow air written by Thomas Connellan from County Sligo in about the 1600s. That's kind of the center of Irish traditional music. And Moving Cloud, which is a Scottish reel that was made pretty famous by Ali Bain. The version that we're doing is a theme and variations So you'll probably hear some of the same thing over and over, but slightly differently as we go through it. I'd like to dedicate this to Wendy Miller.
Excellent, excellent. Okay. All right, our next act, her name is Molly Reed. Molly is an administrative assistant in our container repair shop. You should know that Molly is pursuing a career in country music, and she's working on a project right now with a nationally known producer, and she hopes to have it completed by next summer. The name of this tune is entitled, Do You Know Where Your Man Is? So take it away, Molly.
Thank you.
Night is falling on this honky-tonk city. Country music spilling out on the streets. Well, it sure can sound good to a hard-working man at the end of a hard-working week. Did you kiss him when he left this morning? And does he know that he's needed at home? Somebody else will, and there's good women all alone.
It's 10 o'clock.
Do you know where your man is? And are you sure that he's doing? Blessings. Hold him and show him you care. 'Cause temptation's strong when there's no love at home, and there's so much temptation. Do you know where your man is? And are you sure that he's doing you right? Are you stealing his heart when he's out of your sight? Do you know where your man is?
Thank you very much. Our next couple of folks will be out here momentarily. Let me introduce them first, and then, of course, I have to tell a story about one of them. Delinda White, who I will not tell a story about, has been with UPS for about 4.5 years. Delinda is currently a financial analyst. She's been singing since her childhood, and she enjoys singing at churches and weddings. Now, I'm not sure if that's supposed to be a plug, but her name again is Delinda White, and she sings at weddings. The second part of this act, her name is Laura Hillerick. Laura's been with UPS for 7.5 years. She's currently in employee relations. She's done a bunch of different jobs at UPS. She too has been singing since her childhood, and she joins us again for her second consecutive year. In fact, Laura has sung in every single one of these entertainment extravaganzas. You should know some trivia in case anyone ever asks you that UPS is the largest buyer of turkeys of anyone in the world. We buy about 290,000 of these birds, and every year it's a monumental task for someone to coordinate getting these turkeys out to each of our employees. I have to admit that I was lucky enough and honored enough to have that for a couple of years as my responsibility. I feel it shaped me into the person I am today, and I'm sure you'll see that Laura has been shaped by the turkeys as well. She is talented only because she's having this opportunity to participate in the turkey distribution. So with that in mind, I'd like for everybody to give a warm welcome to Delinda White and Laura Hillerick.
now. When he leaves me, he wears a smile now. As soon as he's away from me, in your arms is where he wants to be.
But you're the one he rushes home to. You're the one he gave his name to. I'll never see his face in the early morning light. You have his mornings, his daytimes, and sometimes I have his nights.
Deceiving me, or am I deceiving myself?
I'm deceiving myself.
But does he love you?
Does he love you?
Like he loves me.
Like he loves me.
Does he think of you?
Does he think of you?
When he's holding me, and does he whisper?
Does he whisper all his fantasies?
Does he love you?
Does he love you?
Like he's been loving me. Oh, I should not lose my temper.
Oh, should not be ashamed.
Thank you very much. Our next act is Christy Raymer. Christy is an administrative assistant in the loss prevention radio room. She's been there for 2 years. Her hobbies include writing, reading, singing, and I find this the most entertaining of her hobbies, and I'm sure I'm glad somebody's doing it. She says, giving UPS supervisors a hard time. Here to sing One Moment in Time, Christy Raymer.
Each day I live to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I face the pain. I rise and fall, yet through remains. I want one moment in time when I'm more than I thought I could be, when all of my dreams are a heartbeat away and the answers are all up to me. Give me
that she gave up singing on the Garth Brooks tour to be here tonight to sing to us. She'll be singing My Strongest Weakness, Sherry Harvey.
Keeper of the gates of wisdom. Please let me in, 'cause I just can't go through another heartache again. Pretty lies and alibis, how could I be so blind? Now all alone, scared I stand, slowly going out of my mind. He was my strongest weakness. I surrendered.
Thank you, Sherry. Our next act, we are very surprised to have this act with us tonight. It's one of those types of things that don't come along very often for the UPS Incredible Entertainment Extravaganza. So I hope everybody's ready. Please sit tight, keep your hands to yourselves, and enjoy Miss Tina Turner.
You know, every now and then, I think you might like to hear something from us. Nice. cheese. There's just one thing.
Job down in the city.
You see, we never, ever do nothing.
Working for the man.
Nice.
Every night and
easy.
Day.
We always
but
do it.
I never lost
nice.
1 minute of
rough.
And I will
but we're going to take the beginning of this song
the thing
and do it
been.
Easy.
Big wheel keep
but then we're going to do the finish.
Turning.
Rough.
Proud Mary.
The way we do.
Bone burning.
Proud Mary.
And we're rolling. Ooh, rolling. Ooh, rolling on the river.
Listen to the story.
Left a good job
down
in the city. Working for the man every night and day. And I never lost 1 minute. Sleeping.
And I was worried
about the way that things might have been.
You know that
big wheel keep on turning. Proud Mary keep on burning. And we're rolling.
Rolling.
Rolling, yeah.
Rolling.
Rolling on a river.
Yeah, on the
river. Saw the good side of the city until I hitched a ride on the riverboat queen. Big wheel keep on turning. Proud Mary keep on burning. And we're rolling.
Rolling.
Rolling, yeah.
Rolling.
Rolling on a river.
And on the
river.
Yeah!
anything you'd like to say to your fans out there?
Fantastic.
Oh, yeah. We're going to hear about that one. Okay. Well, let's keep on rolling. I tell you, I do feel for the next group having to follow such an act like that. But what we're going to do is we're going to move right into our next act, and this is our IS group, who will be doing a medley of something or other. Oh, Jesus, God. Sorry. Okay. The IS group will be doing a something or other to the Disney tunes, and I hope you all enjoy it. So please, IS group, take us away.
Dedicated to our friend Maureen Nolan from all of our IS friends. This evening we will be doing a medley of all of everyone's Disney favorites. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
As it can be,
body bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least, both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast.
Da-dum-da-da-dum. Do you like my new song?
Ta-tum-dee-ta-tum. Such clever lyrics.
Oh, melody first, my dear, and then the lyrics, hmm?
Oh, Pongo. It's her. It's that devil woman.
Oh, must be Cruella, your dearly devoted old schoolmate. Cruella de Vil. That's it.
Cruella de Vil, Cruella de Vil. If she doesn't scare you, no evil thing will.
Oh,
to
Roger.
See her is to take a sudden chill.
Oh.
Cruella, Cruella, she's like a spider waiting for the kill.
Roger,
look
she'll
out,
hear you.
Cruella de Vil.
Let her in, Nanny.
Anita, darling.
How are you?
Miserable, darling, as usual. Perfectly wretched.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more are you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we devoting full time to floating under the sea. Looks like this, little bitches. All you gotta do is look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities are Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life. Wherever I wander, wherever I roam, I couldn't be found off my big home. The bees are buzzing in the tree to make some honey just for me. When you look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants, then maybe try a few.
You eat ants?
You better believe it. And you're gonna love the way they tickle.
Mowgli, look out!
The bare necessities of life will come to you.
Up here.
They'll come to you. Look for the bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife. I mean the bare necessities. That's why a bear can rest at ease with just the bare necessities of life. Now when you pick a paw,
and you wish upon a star, make no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you. If your heart is in your dream, no request is too extreme. like a boat out of the blue. Fate steps in and sees you through.
Together now. Let me go ahead and say the names of the folks that were in there. They're not going to get individual recognition, so this is probably the only way they're going to get it. Brian Minraith, Melanie Miller, Pam Spaulding, Dorothy Hodges, Angie Young, Carl Working, Kevin Sherluck, Robin McDermott, Kevin McNamara, Mike Neff, Barbara Milby, Julie Denton, Harry Steele, Rivera's Girl, James Rivera, Karen Watson, Michael Burns, Pat Hill, Bill Schmidt, Debbie Aldridge, Carl's Girls, Lee Burrell, Jenny Steele, Chris Lawrence, Chris's daughter, Darren Pearl, Vic Smithers, Cheryl McCoy, Steve Weir, Steve LaFranza, Kathy McCubbin, Bill Phelps, Wendell Murdoch, Jeff Pepley, Brian Roy Stan, and Tony Delnay. Okay, that's all of the formal acts that we have for the evening. So before we close up, I'd like to give a nice round of applause for everybody that participated. Okay, and now I'd like to bring up Patty Hobbs. Patty has a few comments for us, some thank yous, and a few various and sundry other things. Here you go, Patty.
Okay, thanks. Well, thanks. I am Patty Hobbs. I have the fortune of being the UPS United Way coordinator this year, and I'm really pleased to stand before you today and thank each and every one of you for coming. I have with me over here to my right Bobby Clayton. He is the Air District Coordinator. There are so many people we want to thank, but just a couple of things to let you know. We've tonight gone the gamut, I think. We had the bare necessities and rolling on the river, and I'm not sure which order that went into. I think there was a little of both in each one of them. But anyway, so what we want to do is just take an opportunity to thank a couple of people. We do want to thank Colonel Quick. They donated the Jiminy Cricket tux for us tonight, so many thanks to them. There's a lot of things that go into a presentation like this, and I don't want to miss anybody, so I wanted to let you know at this second annual entertainment extravaganza, we have had the privilege of working with United Way, and we're real thankful for that. UPS is a primary supporter, I guess, for United Way, and we're real happy to be involved with them. We're going to give you some numbers here in a minute so you can let you know just exactly how much the UPS employees have contributed to the campaign to date. Now, there are a couple of people that I want to bring out here specifically right now. If I could have Mike Lee, Jennifer Lonergan, Deb Lawson, and Peg Underwood up, I would greatly appreciate it. These fine folks are the ones who put this together. Thank you for that hand of applause. Peg Underwood is the director, if you will, of the presentation. Peg, thank you so much. White ribbon, Bobby. Jennifer Lonergan has been the administrative assistant throughout the campaign. I don't know what I would have done without her. Jennifer, red ribbon. Deb Lawson has also been my right-hand arm, and without her, this whole thing probably would have fallen apart. Deb. And our technical director, don't go away, Mike Lee. Mike Lee has been just wonderful. He's the sounds, he's the light, he's the brains of the whole thing. So thank you, Mike, so much. All right, that's the first group that I wanted to thank. I also want to let you know what the numbers are at this point. But before I do that, there are several people who were stagehands tonight. Thanks, special thanks go to Steve Anderson, to Laura Hillerick, to Jennifer Lonergan, and to Jeff Seabe. So thank you very much for putting this together. Just to give you some idea of where we stand, when we started this campaign, we wanted to raise, get this, $1.162 million for United Way. The UPS employees have rallied to the cause, and right now we are at, drum roll please, oh, thank you. We have collected $1,096,384. Thank you. If I could have every UPSer in the audience to please stand up. Every UPSer in the audience, please stand up. Give yourselves a big hand. You all raised that money. Thank you.